Yes, sir, we promised you a great
gorgeous George. Here it
Ready,
comes.
Blassie, the maker of
champions. Andre, the giant.
WrestleMania.
Everyone has a price.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is electric.
Hey, Nelson, man.
You are fine.
The champ is here.
Dissected by his brother, the world heavyweight champion Kane, and tonight the big red monster has a challenge for the Phenom. What's on the twisted mind of the champion? We'll find out tonight.
His way to the ring, weighing in at 323 pounds, is the World Heavyweight Champion, Kane!
Well, at Night of Champions, The Undertaker hit Kane with everything he had, but perhaps for the first time in the Phenom's career, Matt, it wasn't enough.
Well, Kane feels that he's finally emerged from the shadow of his big brother. I mean, just look at the air of confidence on the face of the world's heavyweight champion. And again, now Kane wants to issue a further challenge to his brother. Kane dominated and almost obsessive in his dissection of The Undertaker. So yeah, I'd be confident too.
Well, Kane's power has become too strong for even the dead man to handle. If The Undertaker can't beat Kane, who else has a chance? Chris Masters gets his now.
And making his way to the ring from Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 265 pounds, the Masterpiece, Chris Masters.
Well, you know, Chris Masters saw the match on Sunday night. If Masters isn't terrified right now, I don't know how he can be.
I don't know about terrified. Chris Masters knew that he was contractually obligated for this contest. He's been doing military presses and squats with weights over 500 pounds to prepare himself for this monster, Kane.
Well, Kane proved in Night of Champions he's perhaps the most destructive force the WWE has ever seen.
Well, in the wake of the carnage from Night of Champions, the Masterpiece, Chris Masters, has a daunting task ahead of him tonight, one-on-one with the maniacal, menacing World's Heavyweight Champion, Kane. Notice Kane's aggression right at the start.
Kane, 7 feet, over 300 pounds. And a cover here from Kane. Chris Masters' basically only hope in this match is to lock in the Master Lock.
And how about the fact that 300 pounds just ran over Chris Masters? He came right back up and is now trapped in a side headlock. Oh!
On Sunday night, Kane was simply unbeatable.
Here we go.
Right now, Masters with a swinging neck breaker, getting some offense here, a bit surprising, and a big shoulder block off the rope.
Go! Masters has Kane off of his feet, going for the Master Lock submission.
Trying to lock it in.
If Chris can lock his fingers.
He's done it. He's locked it in.
No one has broken this hold in quite some time.
It's been years. Chris Masters on the verge of a huge upset to kick off Friday Night SmackDown.
Kane looking to reach for the ropes, which will force the break. You can see Masters' fingers are slipping.
The world champion in big trouble here. Can Kane find a way out? Back into the ring post.
Masters holds on.
Masters refusing to release the hold.
If Masters can slide his hands up a little further, he could push Kane's chin into his chest.
And now Kane gets out. He broke the master lock.
Amazing feat of strength on the part of the world's heavyweight champion.
The fact that Kane was able to absorb that pain for as long as he did.
Look at that, a sinister kick to the left knee. And I don't care what your bench press is, if your knee is taken out, you're just like any other man.
And Kane's facial expression just changed.
You know, you see all these guys in the gym throwing up 5 and 6 plates and screaming with terrible form. You kick them in the knee and they're nothing. They usually are nothing anyway, but not Chris Masters.
Now the menacing look on the countenance here of Kane. Kane proved he was bigger, stronger, and more powerful than The Undertaker.
Now let's not lose sight of Kane's wisdom. He's almost sinisterly smart. Stepping on Chris Masters' ankle, think about what that does.
Kane spent 15 years in his brother's shadow, fighting for his moment, his time to step out and become the devil's favorite demon. And on Sunday, that's exactly what Kane did. He executed his plan to perfection.
Kane has said that he took a back seat, he waited, he sat in his lair and allowed The Undertaker to take on opponent after opponent. And Kane studied his brother and he waited for the right time. As soon as The Undertaker showed mercy, Kane thought that his brother was weak. Was Kane correct? Some say yes.
Kane is still the world heavyweight champion, holding the Holy Grail.
And again, the defining moment for Kane, hang on, a cover here coming, Todd.
Hooking the leg now, Masters.
Was when The Undertaker showed mercy to Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania. Right then and there, Kane knew that his lifelong plan was ready to be unhatched.
And what did it say about Kane using the Phenom's own move, the Tombstone Piledriver, to end the match on Sunday night?
Think what you will. Again, it could be mental games, but either way, Kane is still the world's heavyweight champion. Chris Masters is in a disturbing way.
Well, the knee obviously is not bounced back here for Masters. He's struggling to find his vertical base.
Now, Todd, many people felt that The Undertaker wasn't 100% ready for a grueling match at Night of Champions, that he came back too soon, that emotion was the motivation. Now.
Well, The Undertaker, obviously a very proud man. Kane said The Undertaker's pride got in the way. As Kane goes for a cover here.
Pride and envy, part of the 7 deadly sins, and that seems to be what makes up the life of the Brothers of Destruction.
And remember, over the Memorial Day weekend, Kane attacked his brother and left him in a comatose state. Surely The Undertaker was nowhere near 100% on Sunday night.
Is Kane the dominant brother now?
Masters has hung in there longer than many expected.
He's a competitor. Chris Masters understands that a victory here puts him right in line for a World's Heavyweight Championship opportunity.
It's the goal of every superstar to be a world champion. Masters has never climbed that mountain as he comes from the second and flew right into a huge uppercut.
Oh, the knife edge just underneath the jaw.
And now Kane keeping Masters' shoulders on the mat as he beats down on Masters' skull.
Look into the demented monster's eyes.
Kane, who takes such pleasure in others' suffering.
The masochist.
And now a perhaps merciless chokeslam is about to head Chris Masters' way. Up and down, 7 feet in the air.
When have we ever seen anyone manhandle Chris Masters in such a manner? Oh boy, that's a sign, direct sign to his brother, The Undertaker. It's almost eerie. It's like you know something's about to happen and
he's gonna do it. Masters, who weighs 270 pounds, upside down for a Tombstone Piledriver. Just like The Undertaker on Sunday night.
Here is your winner,
the cages of hell.
Another victim for Kane as his reign of terror continues.
Of pain and torment on the face of Kane, finally vindicated from his brother's shadow.
And there was the turning point, Matt, as Kane took out Chris Masters' left knee.
And watch this uppercut right here. Oh. Knife edge just underneath the jaw, and the rest is elementary.
The choke slam and then the tombstone piledriver, a page straight out of the dead man's playbook.
Big brother, this past Sunday, whatever of the dark side remains with you, whatever bit of powers that you still possess,